So when it comes to books, my best guess is you are a personal development junkie. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. And yes. With like a
So I got a two-part question for you when it comes to book. Okay. And that is, other than the Bible, we know the Bible has had more profound effect on your life and mine than any other book. That's hands down. Other than the Bible, what book has had the most impact on your life? And the second part of that question is, what recent book have you come across that you're really excited about and reading, and why?
Okay. So the first one, a couple years back, this one was game changing. I think that word is used way too much, and it's my fault. I use it daily. Game changing is The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy. This book put everything into motion. Now, when real estate, everyone talks about rich dad, poor dad, and I get it. I read that at a young age. Compound Effect just talks about doing the small and simple things that make the big difference between a small company and a great company. It's not big things. It's not like grandiose things. It's not. It's just small and simple, staying consistent on the small and simple things. And it's simple to do, but it's just as simple not to do, is what Darren teaches us. So if you will stay small, consistent at marketing, consistent at returning phone calls, consistently going on appointments, consistently getting contracts, consistently getting paid, and then just go through and consistently make sure you're doing those things, pretty soon you start to move that train. You're pushing that train, and pretty soon it starts to gain momentum. And then we call it Big Mo from Darren Hardy. Big Mo comes in, momentum, and starts to help push that train. That's when things really start to take off.
So think back to when you read the book, The Compound Effect. Can you remember, of course you can, but can you share with us one specific thing that you implemented from that book that you learned to do that really made a big difference?
Yeah, it was the power of becoming someone better. I used to, and he uses a powerful example. He uses how he wanted to find his wife, and he wrote a 40-page document. And you heard this at the seminar. He wrote a 40-page document about, my wife's going to be this, 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 this. And then he heard words from Jim Rohn that says, basically, we get what we want in life when we become the person worthy of it. And so all of a sudden he's like, oh my goodness, like all of a sudden is a paradigm shift. And he wrote a 40-page document on who he would need to be worthy of a person of that caliber of that he was looking for. And he began working on that list of 40 things of what he would need to become. And he says within a couple years, he found the wife of his dreams. And it's eerie how close it was to that 40-page document. So I started realizing quickly, if I want something, if I want to make an extra 100 grand this year, it's who do I need to become to be another 100 grand more valuable to the marketplace? If I want to meet someone of a high caliber, it's who do I need to become? It's not how do I get my face in front of them? That's not going to do anything. It's who do I need to become that would make that high caliber individual say, yeah, come join me for dinner. We have to become individuals and be worthy of what it is that we're looking for in life, if that makes sense. And so that was something I had to work on instantly. It wasn't about this want. It was, who do I need to become to be of value to receive whatever it is that I'm looking for?
That's powerful, Cody. Now, the other question is a recent book that's having a big impact.
Yes, I am reading one right now that is literally changing my life. Key Persons of Influence. So Key Person of Influence, Kevin Harrington and Daniel Priestley. And it is just, instead of KPI being like key performance indicators, which every business owner knows, it's Key Person of Influence. And it's basically being the authority, like yourself, Jay, in the private money area. It's being the authority in your market. So it's great to say, hey, I'm in the niche of real estate, but really be a key person of influence in the micro niche, which is private lending. You're in real estate, but your micro niche is private lending, where mine is wholesaling. So yes, the niche is real estate. You won't see me go outside the box and try to coach five things. I coach one thing. Our micro niche is wholesaling. And this book teaches you how you need to literally bring it down to a micro niche and become the key person of influence, because 80% of the wealth is distributed amongst the top 20%. That's interesting. And the reason is, once you're a key person of influence, all the opportunities start to come to that inner circle, the key people of influence, right? And so Jay is getting opportunity after opportunity after opportunity because he worked so hard to establish his key. He's a key person of influence in the private lending space. So when people are like, hey, I have this deal, I'm going to call Jay. And if Jay doesn't want it, guess who gets it? You guys. But that means it's a poor deal. A good deal comes to the key people of influence. And Jay's one of those. And that's why a good deal, you're not going to pass on. You're going to be like, yeah, I like this opportunity. Ah, I don't like this opportunity. Well, then I guess I'll tell everyone outside the circle, here's a great deal, guys. And that's all you're seeing if you're not the key person of influence.
Ooh, my lands. I know my executive producer that is recording this show right now is like going, my lands, I thought Jay Connor had the energy, but you got it, man. So, Cody, as we wrap up,